Let's take a look at Abhinav's team. It's going to be Vigoroth, Shadow Gligar, Azumarill running Playruff and Ice Beam, Whiscash, Lickitung, Charjabug, and Vigoroth. It's really making a name for itself, as you'd mentioned. 25% usage here, and it's made it to the winner's finals. That's no laughing matter.
And interestingly enough as well, it is a counter user that actually does have play into Gligar. Like, we've seen something like the more traditional Poliwrath on Kobe's team. Fighters like that can struggle quite a bit versus the Gligar, whereas Vigoroth is not taking super effective damage there. And to round out the team with the Shadow Poliwrath, the Whiscash, the Registeel, the Mandibuzz, the regular Gligar here, non-Shadow, and the Cresselia, opting for the same type of attack bonus Future Sight over Moonblast.
And I was gonna say, out of all of the counter users, Vigoroth probably has a reasonably decent matchup into Cresselia, but it's still not all that good. The counters are resisted, body slams are good, but Cresselia is just absolutely so bulky. The Vigoroth is able to withstand any charge attack from that Cresselia, even Future Sight, but I imagine two Grass Knots, two Moonblasts, able to take it out with those Psycho Cuts adding up. So it's still not that strong of a matchup, but significantly better than any other fighter that we see in this field.
Absolutely, and that's what you get from running a Pokemon like Vigoroth. It is incredibly flexible, and it's proved to be very advantageous, as Abhinav has not been playing for switch advantage very often, but instead has opted to play for energy and shields. And it looks like we do have a lock in here in the winner's finals in Portland, Oregon. Game number one, we see Lickitung on the lead versus Cresselia for Kobe.
This is a great lead for Abhinav, but we've seen it before. The Future Sight from Cresselia, sometimes able to take the Zero Shield matchup versus Lickitung, sometimes not. So we talk about things being set in stone sometimes here. Oh, this wins this matchup. Oh, this wins that matchup. But it's not always so clear cut. Kobe going to be going for that heavier hitting Future Sight, going to do a lot of good neutral damage into this Lickitung, probably take it slightly into the yellow. But the question becomes, can Abhinav's Lickitung hang on till that third body slam?
And it looks like it was able to take that Future Sight surprisingly well here. We will see a second body slam thrown by the Lickitung, and again, the no shield by Cresselia. Cresselia, one of the bulkiest Pokemon, able to withstand damage, and it continues to farm as it makes it to Future Sight number two.
Future Sight number two coming through. Lickitung opting to no shield, doing lots of good neutral damage. It hangs on and is going to be able to reach this body slam, but it is caught onto that Whiscash. This will do nice chip damage, and I got to imagine that Abhinav is going to follow up with another Whiscash mirror. The question becomes, which Whiscash gets that attack drop first?
They'll pace identically here. It'll come down to charge attack priority, and Abhinav's Whiscash with the higher attack is going to be able to win charge attack priority here. Kobe going for the no shield. Do we see the debuff? We do not see the debuff once again from Abhinav.
See, Abhinav taking down the note, and that note is going to be saying, no debuff on my Whiscash. The second Scald comes through, and another no debuff. We are 0-for-2, but it is even ground here. We know that Abhinav's Whiscash wins charge attack priority. However, this time, because of the health differences, now going for the Mudbomb. Mudbomb, I think, is going to get this knockout into the Whiscash. Kobe now losing all of that energy, and in comes Mandibuzz. Mandibuzz is going to be outpaced by this Scald. It's going to do meaningful chip damage. No shield from Kobe. Will we see a attack drop?
The Scald connects into the Mandibuzz. Mandibuzz, again, no debuff here. Mandibuzz continuing to farm and going for a knockout with a Dark Pulse. Two shields on the side of Abhinav. Abhinav choosing not to shield, and the Whiscash will get KO'd.
Bit of an interesting choice, because that Whiscash was not really threatened by those Snarls at all. Coming in with the Gligar. The Gligar has health advantage, but the Mandibuzz likes this matchup. Kobe going for the Aerial Ace bait, picks up the first shield from Abhinav. Abhinav's not gonna be happy with that. That was not a very impactful charge attack. Now I imagine Kobe probably going straight for Dark Pulses afterwards. Good timing from Abhinav, getting off this Aerial Ace first. The Mandibuzz is now into the yellow, where Aerial Ace plus Wing Attacks will threaten a knockout.
The Gligar is still extremely healthy. Kobe now going for the harder hitting Dark Pulse, and it does get shielded. Abhinav will be baited once, but not twice, shielding up that Dark Pulse as Gligar continues to get closer and closer to back-to-back Aerial Aces.
Patience from Abhinav here, over farming. I think he's going to want to make sure that he goes into a potential Cresselia switch here with energy, actually counter switching, catching the grass knot. This is great for Abhinav, a complete undercharge by Kobe, hoping that the grass knot does not pick up the knockout, but it still does. The Gligar comes back in. Will it be able to get a farm down? No, Abhinav opting for an aerial ace.
Kobe does still have a shield on his side here. He's not going to use it here. The aerial ace picks up the knockout onto the Cresselia. Back in comes the Mandibuzz, but the Mandibuzz does not have any energy. Mandibuzz continuing to farm, and it's taken quite a lot of damage here. This is a shadow aerial ace. Can Gligar pick up a knockout here with a second aerial ace?
Aerial Ace comes through, gets shielded, a charge attack tie here. Aerial Ace, Gligar wins the charge attack priority. Aerial Ace coming through. I don't think it's going to be quite enough to pick up the knockout. Will the Mandibuzz's Aerial Ace pick up a knockout for Kobe?
This will be very close. Mandibuzz not known for its attack stat. Aerial Ace is going to connect. Gligar survives, and we see the Gligar wing attack registering before the Snarl, and the game one win for Abhinav.
It looked like neither of those trainers there knew who was going to win at that end game. A few HP for both Pokemon after the Aerial Ace coming through. Aerial Ace, not the strongest charge attack, but a very, very cheap one. Kobe, maybe if he went for a Dark Pulse, could have made it, but I didn't think that it was going to be able to survive another wing attack.
Absolutely. And as we go into the replays here, we see the Scald again. No debuff for Abhinav, going for the Dark Pulse to guarantee a KO here. And he's more than happy to let this through and trust in that Shadow Gligar to try and take the victory.
No fast attack pressure coming from that Wish Cash, so great choice there. Dark Pulse, no shielded, no shields remaining. A amazing catch by Abhinav to secure him a chance to win the game. Shaking his head, thinking, I cannot survive this Aerial Ace, but Aerial Ace getting charged up. All the bubbles hit by Kobe, not enough to knock out. One wing attack comes in faster than the Snarl and is able to secure Abhinav the victory.
And that can be the advantage of running these shorter turn duration fast moves like wing attack is in that situation. One fast move will KO either Pokemon, but two turns, the damage will register before the three turn fast move, and Abhinav, by the narrowest of margins, able to take the game one victory.
Kobe and Abhinav are resetting, thinking about game number two. And as a reminder to myself, to you, Henry, and to those at home, this is a best of five. So no backs are up against the wall yet. They still, Abhinav still needs to win two battles. Kobe needs to win three in order to secure victory and move on towards the grand finals. There's a lot of room here for adjustment. There's a lot of room for figuring out the best attack pattern in order to secure victory.
What adjustments will be made here on the side of Kobe as he looks for the equalizer here? Game number two, we have the lock-ins. It's Whiscash on the lead into the Shadow Poliwrath, and Abhinav is ABA weak to this Poliwrath.
Yes, really forced to stay in here because Whiscash has the option to go for Mud Bomb. Is not taking super effective damage from those counters. Maybe, I thought he was swiping maybe a little bit to pretend it was a Scald, but the Mud Bomb is shielded. That Shadow Poliwrath would have taken a decent amount of neutral damage, and with no debuff yet onto that Wish Cash, shielding the first one makes the most sense.
Going for the Scald, we see no Protect Shield by Abhinav. The Scald does not pick up the knockout. The one HP survive, and Whiscash leaves with a parting shot here, able to connect with a Mud Bomb that does very valuable damage onto the Poliwrath.
The Gligar is now going to be able to come in and farm down, but will have to take at least one Icy Wind in return. Icy Wind double super effective damage is going to be the preferred move here. With the guaranteed attack drop, Gligar is going to get a little bit of more farm. Instead, Kobe opting to save switch into the Cresselia. Abhinav not opting to switch into the Vigoroth is a bit interesting because his attack is dropped, so this dig will do less damage than if he had saved it for later.
And there's the switch into the Vigoroth. One charge move will not knock out here for the Cresselia, so Cresselia is going to need multiple charge moves. Going for the harder hitting Future Sight here. Abhinav, one shield remaining. He will not use it here, and the Future Sight connects, dealing big damage to that Vigoroth.
Vigoroth farming up to multiple Body Slams. It is a charge attack tie, two Body Slams loaded at the same time as Cresselia's Grass Knot. This means that the Grass Knot will threaten a knockout, and Abhinav will need to shield if he wants to get that second charge attack off. Looks like he's debating. Deciding to not shield Grass Knot is enough to pick up the KO.
Kobe with all three Pokemon still available, but for Abhinav, only one left, and it's that Shadow Gligar. Gligar farming up, going for the Aerial Ace to pick up the knockout. Abhinav still has not seen that final Pokemon for Kobe yet, and for Kobe, he's managed to get some very valuable chip damage onto this Shadow Gligar, because a Scald will not be enough to knock out a Shadow Gligar from full HP, but this Gligar has taken about 20 to 25% of its HP already.
And with no options for super effective damage into this Wish Cash, things are looking dire for Abhinav. He gets the shield on the Aerial Ace bait. However, a singular dig or a singular Aerial Ace after this will not be enough to pick up a knockout. Shielding the Scald makes sense. This is going to do a lot of super effective damage. The attack drop does come in, I think, really settling this for Kobe as a victory.
Either way, the dig, as you had mentioned, will not be enough to KO, but it does help you feel a little more confident in this matchup here. No shields remaining for Abhinav. Abhinav able to take the 1-0 advantage, but Kobe with the equalizer here in this best of five series. And now, as we look ahead to game number three, whoever wins this game number three will have a very big advantage in this best of five series.
Yes, only needing to win one more is such a great feeling, so comfortable. You know that you have some wiggle room. You have some room to adjust afterwards. I think game number two was a really great showing by Kobe in terms of team composition, putting that Wish Cash in the back to thrive and survive. Scald coming into the Wish Cash to pick up almost the knockout, one HP and a Mud Bomb coming back, but it does not do enough damage to this Poliwrath to threaten a knockout, putting it just into the yellow.
And back in comes the Gligar. Gligar all by itself, whereas Kobe still has three Pokemon remaining, and the Whiscash in the back proving to be too much for the Gligar to handle, and Scald picks up the knockout, and we get the equalizer here.
Our battlers on stage are preparing for game number three here. It's almost as if we were now completely reset in a best of three match. Whoever wins two more battles will move forward. Abhinav, really unfortunate positioning for the Vigoroth in that last battle with the positioning against Cresselia, not able to rack up enough damage. The timing of that switch meant that the second Body Slam came out at the same time as the second charge attack from Cresselia, which really limited that Vigoroth's damage output.
It looks like we do have lock-ins here for game number three. We see that Vigoroth return to the field, this time in much better alignment, as it gets a neutral matchup here going up against Whiscash.
Whiscash versus Vigoroth is a solid matchup for Vigoroth. Vigoroth with a better attack stat, able to win charge attack priority. Body Slam, good neutral damage into this Whiscash.
And we will see the Body Slam connect. Kobe over farming slightly, going for the Scald. Scald not going to be enough to pick up a knockout, but as always, does it get that attack drop? The Scald connects into the Vigoroth, and Scald does not get that debuff.
That's going to be great for Abhinav, because now Body Slam might threaten a knockout. Instead, Kobe going to catch this Body Slam onto the Cresselia. Cresselia extremely bulky. Abhinav likely putting the Shadow Gligar onto this Cresselia because it does not take super effective damage or even double super effective damage from the Grass Knot.
Cresselia continuing to farm, going for the Future Sight here. Future Sight will not get a knockout, but it's going to make its presence felt here. Abhinav lets it through. The Future Sight connects, dealing big damage onto that Gligar.
I think that's going to put the Shadow Gligar into the range of a Grass Knot, so Kobe is very comfortable going straight Grass Knot from here on out. Aerial Ace bait getting shielded up by Kobe. That's a sigh of relief from Abhinav, and they charge attack tie here. Great timing from Abhinav, throwing it as soon as that Grass Knot is reached. Dig is going to come through and not quite threaten a knockout, but put that Cresselia into potential farm down range for another one of his Pokemon. We know he loves playing for shield and energy advantage, and we actually see the shield come up playing for switch advantage here.
So Abhinav adjusting the playstyle a little bit. He does have the pacing advantage in this matchup. Can he get a farm down? He does get the farm down! The perfect farm down for Abhinav. We're gonna see Kobe sending in the Gligar. Abhinav able to quickly react and fire off this aerial ace.
Question is, now that Abhinav knows all three Pokemon, does he switch out? Yes, he does, into his own Wishcash. Now, Kobe's Wishcash is at a significant health disadvantage, a charge attack tie here. The dig going through at the same time as Sculpt. This dig does not threaten a shield for Abhinav, but the Sculpt, I think, will threaten a shield for Kobe. The shield comes up anyways from the Sculpt, or for the dig, excuse me. The Sculpt comes through, pulls out the second shield. We are now completely shields down.
Does this Sculpt get the debuff here for Abhinav? It does get the debuff. And now we're going to see a switch out because of that. Kobe switching into his own Wizcash, going for the Sculpt. He's managed to reset the debuff on the Gligar and looking to apply an attack drop onto that Wizcash of Abhinav.
Sculpt putting the opposing Wizcash into the yellow. Overfarmed by Abhinav. Really great play here, recognizing there's still time before Kobe reaches his next charge attack. I can build up extra energy to take back into that Gligar matchup. The Sculpt picks up the knockout, and will we see the simul pace here to the dig? It is a charge attack tie.
Oh my, Kobe making it to the dig. The shake of the head from Abhinav, as that is an incredibly important charge attack priority here. That Sculpt damage was needed. Abhinav's remaining Pokemon do not have a lot of HP left. We see the Gligar and the Vigoroth. Vigoroth can make it to a charge move, but this is a non-Shadow Gligar. An attempt at a catch onto the Gligar. Kobe goes for the farm down and gets the farm down!
The question now becomes, we see actually tapping the Rock Slide. Rock Slide is going to be neutral damage. I think it's just slightly more damage than a Body Slam. Rock Slide comes through into the Gligar, not able to pick up the knockout. The charge attack tie means that the dig comes through for Kobe and is going to secure him a 2-1 lead over Abhinav in the winner's finals.
What an incredible game there. The attempted catch at the end, even though the catch was not successful, those wing attacks were important to Abhinav, trying to get that Gligar as low as possible, going for the Rock Slide, does slightly more damage, but unfortunately, if that was a Shadow Gligar, maybe this is a different story, but as the regular Gligar able to withstand the Rock Slide, and Kobe, the underdog story here in Portland, one win away from the grand finals.
You can't understate it. To go from 48th to potentially top two is an incredible change from one year to the other. In the replay, we see the farm down. That was a great play by Abhinav and an unfortunate charge attack tie here. The dig coming through, able to pick up the knockout into the Wishcash. Wishcash is down, and now Abhinav has a choice. Which Pokemon do I go into? It's going to be the Vigoroth, an attempted catch onto the Gligar. Gligar does not have enough health left to reach that aerial ace.
And right at the end here, the charged attack tie, the Rock Slide, hoping against hope that it's enough to knock Gligar out of the sky, but Gligar able to withstand the damage. They're just not quite enough. And Kobe, as we had mentioned here, the underdog in this tournament, played last year in Portland, his first tournament, 48th, now in a potential position, in a win and in game to the grand finals here. Abhinav versus Kobe, the battlers have locked in. Take it away, Phoebe.
And we see the leads. It's going to be a great lead for Kobe. Cresselia into Wishcash. Double super effective damage options available. A quick switch into Gligar for Abhinav. And no great answer on Kobe's side. Gligar and Poliwrath in the back. You could switch into the mirror, but you're going to be down energy. The play likely is going to be throw a Grass Knot, get a chip and dip or shield advantage, and then switch into your own Gligar.
We do see the shield advantage obtained by Kobe, but Abhinav does have a pretty significant energy lead here. And baiting out the Gligar is potentially helpful here as we do see that Charjabug lurking in the back. So the team comp from Abhinav so far working out quite nicely as he makes it to yet another aerial ace. Kobe, with the shield advantage here, uses the first shield here.
The one thing I want to point out is because Cresselia paces to the first Grass Knot in 6 Psycho Cuts, Abhinav's actually at an energy advantage because it's more than 5 wing attacks. He lost the shield to the Grass Knot, but he had 6 extra wing attacks because of that pacing and is going to be able to outpace the Gligar here. Two additional charge attacks. It is, however, a Shadow versus non-Shadow. The Aerial Ace is not going to be able to threaten a knockout. The question is, as always, will Abhinav go for switch advantage or shield advantage?
He's thinking about it here. This is a tough decision to make. He decides to go for switch advantage here. He is going to go for the wing attack farm down, leaving with energy. And if we take a look at Kobe's remaining Pokemon, he does not have a lot of fast move pressure here to remove Gligar from the field of play.
I think the counter down will be possible, instead opting to bring in the Cresselia. The Cresselia is going to have to take at least one dig. I think if it goes for a Psycho Cut down, the Gligar might be able to reach an Aerial Ace. It's going to be incredibly close.
Cresselia continuing to farm here, not opting to go for the farm down, instead going for the Grasdaunt here. Grasdaunt will be able to pick up the knockout, but with switch advantage, Abhinav now gets to free that Whiscash from having to deal with a Grasdaunt, as in comes Charjabug.
And shields are equalized at this point. The one thing that Kobe has, and oh, the catch of the X-Scissor into Poliwrath. This is going to be resisted damage. The question is, does he stay in this matchup or does he switch out? He stays in four now, doing two more Volt Switches, not enough to get to the discharge. It is actually three, but it comes before the Icy Wind. This is not debuffed. It's going to be enough to knock out. Look at how much damage those Volt Switches did.
Those Volt Switches tearing through the Poliwrath. Down goes the Poliwrath. Back in comes that Cresselia. Cresselia going for the Future Sight. This move does get same type attack bonus, but Charjabug is a very bulky Pokemon. Future Sight not going to be enough to pick up the knockout here. Continuing to farm is the Charjabug. Charjabug firing off the X-Scissor, and this is super effective damage onto that Cresselia.
The really hard thing for Abhinav here is that he's using Charjabug. Charjabug is four turn fast attacks. It makes catching really hard, but he does it anyways. A Grass Knot into his Whiscash. This is double super effective caught damage. It's going to not be enough to knock out, but the Cresselia is so low on health, it almost looks like a Mud Shot down will be possible. The Mud Bomb is not able to be reached because the Cresselia faints. That is going to be 2-2, a rare, decisive game number five here.
Unbelievable plays from Abhinav, the terrible lead, but understanding the Gligar save switch, very, very strong, and able to shield up because you saw Kobe wanted to go for the chip and dip strategy, but Abhinav said no. And as you had mentioned, Cresselia, six Psycho Cuts to a move here, and then in the end game, the Charjabug farming up, Kobe doing what he can. He's been core broken. He makes the beautiful catch, but we see Poliwrath 14 turns away from the Icy Wind, Charjabug 12 turns away from the discharge, picking up the knockout, and the Charjabug, the beautiful catch into the Grass Knot. Oh my goodness.
I'm not 100% convinced it was necessary at the point, but you know, you love to see it. I was talking about how hard it is for him to catch, but perfect timing, able to go into the Whiscash, recognizing the Grass Knot's gonna be enough to knock out. I can very comfortably take it. I will outpace the Cresselia afterwards and gets the farm down. I'm gonna send my steak back to the chef. It's rare, it's game number five. We are locked in. Lickitung into Whiscash. A reversal, a great lead this time. Abhinav having grass type damage to potentially a go against Kobe's ground and water type.
We see Kobe staying in this matchup to start with, as Whiscash does have the pacing advantage here, going to fire off the Scald, and we will see a no shield from Abhinav. This Scald will do meaningful damage and potentially go for a debuff here, and gets the debuff.
We've seen it time and time again. Abhinav's been willing to bait with the Body Slam. He does it here. It'll help him pace to the next Power Whip a little bit quicker. Pulls the shield up from Kobe, nods in recognition. Okay, you got me, but I'm going to land another Scald before your Power Whip, and maybe I'll get a second attack debuff.
This Scald is gonna be no-shielded. Lickitung, a very, very bulky Pokemon, able to withstand both of these charge attacks. We do not see the debuff continuing to farm up here, and this time it is going to be the Power Whip and the no-shield by Kobe. This is debuff, but this is double super effective damage.
Double super effective damage, not able to pick up the knockout. However, no shields have been used for Abhinav. Another no shield. This is going to knock out. He could have used one more shield to secure switch advantage for even shields, but instead, Mr. I don't care about switch advantage again, opting for shield advantage, gets the farm down with Gligar. In comes Cresselia, and this is actually so good for Abhinav. He got switch advantage anyways.
He did. We see the dig catch. Oh my, catching the dig onto the Gligar, able to store energy for later. Catch the dig, it does absolutely nothing. And in the back, it is going to be that Whiscash. Whiscash up a shield, but the energy that's stored on Cresselia could be very game impacting later on.
It's double resisted by the flying type. However, it might put the Gligar within range of Scald and Mudshot. The attack drop comes through. Kobe shakes his head in frustration. Now this dig is going to be doing even less damage. Abhinav very comfortably, no shielding here, recognizing that, oh, I think I'll be able to reach another Scald before two digs are reached. It comes in one fast attack before. Scald going to do good super effective damage. I think it's gonna still be a bit short of the knockout as this is not a Shadow Gligar.
Gligar able to withstand that damage. We see another debuff here. And at minus two attack, this dig, I don't believe, is going to be enough to knock out the Whiscash here. The debuff for Abhinav. We've been waiting for them all weekend, and they arrive when they matter the most, making it to another Scald. No shields remaining for Kobe, and all that's left for him in the back is the Cresselia versus that Shadow Gligar of Abhinav.
Yeah, Abhinav opting to use the energy there because he wants to make sure that that Gligar is unable to be switched out of. Meaning that Kobe is now on his last Pokemon. A great no shield by Abhinav, recognizing that it's likely going to be the Grass Knot first. If he happens to no shield two Grass Knots and then gets hit by a Future Sight, that is maybe a lose condition here. Throwing the dig, no shields are left for Kobe. It's gonna be good neutral damage. Takes about half of Cresselia's remaining HP.
Another Grass Knot thrown by Kobe, but Abhinav, as you mentioned earlier, he has not shielded anything yet. Two Protect Shields still available. The Grass Knot does get shielded, continuing to farm up, making it to the dig on charged attack priority. And this means that Abhinav will be the winner of the Winners Finals in a 3-2 series and will advance to the Grand Finals here in Portland, Oregon.
Mr. I don't care about switch advantage, loses switch advantage, gets it back again, and pushes his way to the Grand Finals. Congratulations, Abhinav.